Minus four at 7:34 at the airport. Good morning, everyone. Mounties in Ottawa believe they have quashed an alleged terrorist conspiracy after arresting a third person. 21-year-old Suleiman Mohammed is now charged with conspiring to take part in the activity of a terrorist group. Police say Mohammed is connected to the recent arrest of twin brothers Ashton and Carlos Larmont. Police say at least one of the Larmont brothers intended to travel overseas for terrorist purposes. Authorities say these three arrests show there are active, radicalized individuals living in our country. A section of the subway system in Washington, D.C. is still closed this morning after one person died, dozens of others suffering smoke inhalation. This during the rush home yesterday. Three of the injured are still in critical condition in hospital this morning. An electrical fire is to blame, the smoke forcing hundreds of people out of one of the busiest metro stations in the U.S. Capitol. People pouring onto the street covered in soot. As you can see, at one point, a lot of people were trapped inside subway cars. A lot of them started to faint as the fire consumed all the air in the tunnel.
The person had been on the train, was in distress, was evacuated from the train by emergency services, and was subsequently pronounced dead.
Officials think an electrical arc involving the third rail and the power supply cables to the third rail is the likely cause of the electrical fire. Water along the subway tracks may also be a factor. Officials overseas now say divers have recovered the second black box and may have finally found the fuselage from Air Asia Flight 8501. Reports are the fuselage was found northeast of where the tail section was previously recovered from the bottom of the Java Sea. This is not confirmed officially yet by the National Search and Rescue Agency, but crews have reportedly also brought the cockpit voice recorder to the surface. Both black boxes will now be sent to a lab where experts will hopefully be able to recover key pieces of data that may explain why Flight 8501 fell from the sky about 2 weeks ago, all 162 people on board dying. A lot of the victims are believed to be still inside the fuselage of the Air Asia aircraft. Back here in our city, questions and confusion regarding a controversial plan to allow cycling along Stephen Avenue downtown. Right now, it's illegal to ride your bike along Stephen Ave. The city's transportation manager says there is no plan to put a dedicated cycle-only lane along the pedestrian mall with barriers separating people and bikes. There is a plan to change the rules, allowing cyclists to use Stephen Ave during certain times of the day.
The intent on Stephen Avenue is to share the existing space. It's not to create a dedicated lane only for cyclists in that pedestrian mall. What we want to do is during the off-peak periods have that have the space available for both pedestrians and cyclists.
If you're not separating people, why that cost $595,000?
The project will cost about $600,000, as you heard, to change all the signs and to also build new gates along Stephen Avenue.